Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. Today I'm going to show you a little landscape print I did today and printed out a few days ago. So let's have a look after the intro. So this print I did is an area in the middle of Iceland, very close to the actual middle of Iceland, up in the highlands. And this area is called Nýdalur, this area here. And this glacier here is Tungnafellsjökull, and that's probably a mouthful for most of you guys. Actually, it's quite a mouthful also in Icelandic to say, so I don't blame you for trying to struggling with this name, Tugnafellsjökull. But this area here is there's a hut here in this area and the road that goes through this area, and here's a small area of some grass and moss, but for most part the area is just rocks and sand and mud. And but in this place here, on the other side of the glacier, is a geothermal activity. So there are some hot springs here, and you can go bathing in the hot springs. But it's very difficult to get to this area because you have to walk from the hut over here, and that's maybe half a day trip to go over here. There was a road in the area from the other side, but now that road is closed, so you can't go there anymore. But over here is also a river, and there's a glacier at this corner here that's called Vatnajökull. That's the biggest glacier in Iceland, and this is just a small part of it showing up at this corner in this print. But Vatnajökull glacier is the biggest glacier in Europe. And it's very, very big glacier, but this glacier here is a relatively small glacier in Iceland. But those mountains here have a lot of colors in them because of the geothermal activity. So it's a really beautiful area to spend a day hiking up this valley here and up to these mountains and see the glaciers over here. And you can also go by road over around the glacier over to this area. But here are several glacier rivers that can be difficult to cross. And in hot summer days, the snow and the ice in the glacier melts very fast, and the rivers can be difficult to pass, and sometimes people have to wait until the night time when the rivers have gotten smaller to cross them. So that can be quite a challenge to travel in this area also, even though you have a big jeep. But this is the print of the area, and I just painted this today and printed out yesterday. Today I had a little problem when I printed the model out, because I didn't realize the height of the model. It was printed like this. The height of the model was 230 millimeters, but the Prusa only goes to 200 millimeters in height. So when the nozzle came to this height, it pushed on the model, and the model fell down, and the printer continued to print in the mid-air. I cancelled that print when I woke up. It was printing during the night, and when I woke up I noticed this and cancelled the print. So this I cleaned off the gunk that was cluttering on top of the print, but otherwise it came out okay. It has a two-color print because I ran out of white filament, and before I went to sleep I changed to the purple filament, so it continued with the purple, and both filaments are rigid ink PLA, so the temperature settings are the same for both materials. So it didn't matter to change the filament mid-print. But this is the model, and I'm gonna find someone to receive this model. I'm gonna send it away to some YouTube channel, like I've done with several other models. So I haven't decided yet who's gonna get it. I'm also printing another model. You can see in the corner of the video, the PrusaCam Raspberry Pi camera. That's in a printer camera cabinet. It's showing the print going on. And hope you like the setup I got with the multiple cameras and the PrusaCam also going on when I have prints going on. But for now, this is what I want to show you, and I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.